We are in the museum right now. Battleship submarine, where do we go first? The USS Drum is a Gato-class submarine of the United States Navy. The ship was named after the drum, a type of fish, and the drum is listed as a museum ship in Mobile, Alabama at Battleship Memorial Park, which you will see the USS Alabama. The drum was commissioned on November 1, 1941 with Commander Robert H. Rice. The shakedown training of the drum was set out to join the war in the Pacific. The drum departed midway and began her first war patrol cruising off the coast of Japan. She sunk three ships. Her efforts to crew were awarded the Submarine Combat Patrol insignia. When it was all said and done, the Drum received a total of 12 battle stars for her World War II service. She is credited with sinking 15 ships and a total of 80,000 tons of enemy shipping, eighth highest of all U.S. submarines. The Drum was donated to the USS Alabama Battleship Commission on April 14, 1969, and towed to Battleship Alabama Memorial Park on May 18th, 1969. It was opened to the public in July 4th of 1969. The drum was moored in the waters behind the Alabama, but sustained damage during the hurricane seasons and was eventually dry docked. Let's take a journey below deck and see what life was like on a submarine in World War II in this fabulous museum. Torpedoes. Incredible thing is, you look at the amount of stuff that this thing sunk. It's quite a bit.
Well, it did landmines. It did patrol in Hawaii.
Oh, here's the dining room. I couldn't. I got this.
See it? Yeah. Officer pantry.
You want me to hold the water?
Officers.
Well, when we were on the surface and the diving alarm would go off, we'd have about 60 seconds to get up from being on lookout to get down here, because the two lookouts, when the diving alarm goes off, become the bow and stern planesmen down here
to turn
these wheels, which operate those fins you saw on the front and the back,
I'm not coming out,
and that's what made us dive. that and the submarine getting heavy, because when the diving alarm went off, the chief of the watch could pull some of these back.
The air vent being closed, but once the chief opened the air vent, water floods in the ballast tanks, we start getting heavy. The lookouts have gotten down, they've been given an order, make your depth 120 feet, 10 degree down bubble, so the two planes would turn their wheels, they'd watch this bubble in oil, and when we get near maybe 7 or 8 degrees down, they would start to ease off so that you glided into your proper depth. And then when you are
there's a ship on the horizon.
At depth.
There's what? There's a ship on the horizon.
Yeah. I always tell the kids, don't fire the torpedo and sink the battleship, it'll get the park upset. When we're down, they would bleed some high pressure air into the atmosphere and look at a barometer to make sure that the pressure was holding. If the pressure wasn't holding, that means air is leaking out and water's coming in. And we don't like water coming in.
So you were on this?
I was on two diesels like this, but not this one. But this one's here. And since 2006, I've been coming with a party of guys that I served with in the 60s, and we do this.
That's awesome.
We actually used to, in the first years, chip and paint and clean bird doo-doo and do whatever needed to be done in the morning and then do this in the afternoons. But now that one of us is over 80, I will be 80 in a couple of weeks, they won't let us do hard labor, so damn the bad luck. Come here and do this.
Well, that's awesome. Thank you.
That's what I looked like in the 60s. At the start of a patrol, we had a haircut contest, and that was incredibly stupid for me to do that because we were going above the Arctic Circle, submerged in the winter off the coast of Russia to sneak around, and my head got really cold.
So how long does it take to get accustomed to being in a submarine?
Well, when you go to submarine school, you go out a couple of days, you get a little taste of it, but it was a real culture shock when I first reported, but they keep you really busy, and it's something I had wanted for years, so, you know, you just...
It's your dream.
Just dream, you just live your dream, even if parts of it really weren't good at that time, working 18 hours a day and whatnot, but you do what you gotta do.
Right.
If you want it.
Right.
That's
no good. No good for
me
you.
A life
that's
lesson right
well,
there.
Yeah. That's the way it should be, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
You was on a submarine?
I was on two diesels back in the 60s.
You get back home tonight, pick up your clothes tomorrow morning, give them a sniff test, and you'll smell these.
Wow.
Not happening a
lot. Yeah, you better love it.
Just stick your head up there, baby. Keep going.
Oh, there's the kitchen. There's the grill. That's pretty cool.
That's really cool how they have this set up.
Mess hall. Refrigerator down there. So,
1, 2, 3.
Leave them sandals.
Well, they wouldn't have had this nice air conditioning.
You know, this would have been like the, you'd had been kind of a rebel to do that. You'd had to kind of been a different guy.
His passion to go to do this.
Because this wasn't for your normal guy. Couldn't be claustrophobic. Just if you like mechanical stuff, this is pretty unbelievable.
How you doing?
Hi, how are you?
Good. This is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty simple though. You know, it's all mechanical, so it is not.
So it makes sense. You know.
Yeah. So you know, if you're a little mechanically inclined, you can, you know, you can figure it out pretty quickly. Yeah. But it's like owning a Tesla. The whole thing is off a battery.
Right.
Yeah. And all we do is charge the battery.
So, right.
So the battery is, there's one battery underneath the bunk room over there, and then there's another battery underneath the officer's quarters. And so the whole boat runs off of that battery, those two batteries.
How long could you stay out?
We could stay about 24 hours. The battery is now dead, and then there's no more air in the boat.
Good.
So you had to come up because we can't breathe anymore. So the only air we had when we went down was the air that we had when
you went down, right?
Yeah, it was like swimming underwater. Take a deep breath and swim, and then you need to come up. Same thing.
Right.
So we had to come up every night, and then recharge.
How do you charge then? Does the motor then generate the chargers? This is more of a generator kind of thing.
Yeah. See the generator right there?
Okay.
So that's it. So this motor turns that generator.
So you're really not running. You have to come up to get air.
Come up to get air. The air, fresh air, comes in through here.
Right.
Because if you get any water in the pipe, it just dumps on the floor.
Right.
You don't want air in the engines,
right,
of course. But that's all it does.
That's interesting. I didn't know that.
So did you love it like the other gentleman?
Did I love it?
Or did you love being in a submarine?
Not at the time, probably. It was a pain.
I like that.
I love it now.
Yeah, yeah. I appreciate your time.
I wanted to be in a submarine, but on land.
There it is right there. That's what he was talking about right there. Fuel oil purifier. That's incredible. Showing all the amps and
and then I also would do Carswell Air Force Base right there. I think about Dallas Fort Worth.
Yes, yes, there is. I don't remember if it's Carswell or not, but there is one there because one of my old captain, his mom worked for the Air Force and that was where she was going to.
I know they had F-16.
That's a propeller right there.
How far was it?